Welcome once again to the Post and Cocky Preview Show. We're here in week three. I'm your host, Jeremy Sullivan, alongside the lead analyst of the Post and Cocky, Ryan Mace. The Gamecocks traveled up to Athens this past weekend to take on Georgia. And again, most would agree that the winner of this game would be the front runner in the SEC East. This game turned out to be a pretty high-scoring game.
Right, it did. Georgia took an early 6-0 lead in the game on a couple of Blair Walsh field goals. And Carolina was once again held to 0 points in the first quarter, as they did in ECU back in week one. They were able to get on the board in the second quarter. Garcia hooked up with Jeffrey for a 34-yard touchdown. And the score kind of went back and forth throughout the game. And in the fourth quarter, South Carolina was able to take control of the game with their running game. Lattimore finished the game with 176 yards on the ground and a touchdown. Garcia didn't look too sharp, but he did finish the game with 142 passing yards, had a couple of interceptions, but also had that touchdown pass to Jeffrey. The defense and special teams came up big for Carolina, and Clowney had a big sack in the fourth quarter, stripped Aaron Murray, and Melvin Ingram, who had 2 touchdowns on the day, got one of his touchdowns on that play, picked it up and scored on a fumble recovery. So it was kind of a tough game for Carolina, but they did find a way to win, and that's going to be a huge momentum for them heading into week three.
And despite those big plays on defense, there are still a few concerning factors that Ellis Johnson and the rest of the defensive coaches are hopefully looking at this week.
Right. The defense has allowed 39.5 points per game so far this year. They allowed 37 to ECU and 42 to Georgia last week, and the secondary has been the weak point for them. They allowed 4 touchdown passes last week to Aaron Murray, and they also struggled against ECU. Their defensive front hasn't looked bad in getting pressure on the quarterback, but they do need to look more into stopping the running game, which is something that they're going to need to do if they want to beat Navy's triple option this week. They've made some big plays on defense, but if they want to continue winning in the SEC, they're definitely going to need to tighten up in the secondary.
The defense this week is going to need to be especially focused as they take on Navy's triple option, which quite frankly gives trouble to a lot of defenses.
Mm-hmm. It's a tough offensive scheme to stop. They feature a running quarterback, a quick fullback, and a running back, so the defense has 3 different weapons to worry about. Their quarterback, Chris Proctor, has rushed for nearly 200 yards this year, and he's only thrown for less than 150, so that kind of shows you how much they run and pass. And their running back, Alexander Teach, has also run for 167 yards. They average 400 yards per game rushing, so it's an attack that could give Carolina some trouble.
Now, what should Carolina keep in mind this Saturday to make sure they come away with a win here at home?
Well, the first and most obvious key to victory for them is going to be containing the triple option. If they can neutralize the pitch man for Navy and force Chris Proctor into some throwing situations, which they don't do that often, I think they can find some success on defense. If they can control the clock and keep the ball out of Navy's hands, keep the defense off the field, I think they can stay fresh throughout the game and put themselves in a good position to win. Thoroughly, if they can take care of the football, don't turn it over, if Garcia can make some smart decisions, I think they'll be able to find some success on the offensive side of the ball, won't have any trouble scoring points.
All right, so you've told us what both teams need to do to make sure they come away with a win this week. Who do you think is ultimately going to come away with the win?
I think South Carolina. I like them to start the season 3-0. They usually play pretty well at home, and I think Spurrier will have the guys fired up, and I like them winning the game 42-24.
Now that we've heard Ryan's prediction, we'd also like to hear from you. Please leave your comments on our Facebook page or send us a tweet at Post and Cocky. This week's closest prediction to the final score will be our guest picker for next week's Post and Cocky predictions. We'll see you next time as we preview the SEC matchup between South Carolina and Vanderbilt.